Good afternoon, students. I'm Professor Anjula. Today we will discuss our new topic, which is known as synapse. So basically what synapse is, it is a junction between two neurons and it is called synapse. In the previous session, we have discussed about the conduction of nerve impulse. So the junction between two neurons, as we have seen the structure of neuron, the junction is known as the synapse. So it is a specialized junction where the transmission of nerve impulse, or you can say information, takes place between a nerve fiber and another nerve fiber, or a muscle cell or a gland cell. So basically you can say the transmission between two nerve cells, or from a nerve cell to a muscle cell, or from a nerve cell to a gland cell, takes place with the help of a synapse. So it is not anatomical continuation, there is no anatomy there, but it is a physiological continuity between two nerve cells. So as far as the structure is concerned, it has a presynaptic synaptic knob, a postsynaptic part, and a cleft. So the presynaptic ending contains neurotransmitters, mitochondria, and another cell, organelles. The postsynaptic part contains receptor for the neurotransmitters, and the synaptic cleft, which is the space between pre and postsynaptic endings, it is 220 nanometer wide. So this is the structure. This is the presynaptic neuron, this is the postsynaptic neuron, and this is the cleft part. So these are known as the synaptic vesicles, which contains the neurotransmitters. There are channels present which are known as voltage gated calcium channels. This part is known as axon terminal. This is the cleft and this is the dendrite spine. And these are the receptors for neurotransmitters. These neurotransmitters are released here and these are collected by these neurotransmitter receptors. This is the structure of a synapse. So you can say this is the postsynaptic, which one is the receiving cell. This is the axon terminal and this is the presynaptic. So you can say there is no structure there, but this is a you can say a physiological part where the connection between two neurons is established. The main function of the synapse is just simple to transmit impulses or to generate action potential from one neuron to another. So two types of synapses are there. One is the chemical synapse, another one is the electrical synapse. So this is the chemical synapse, which I have told you earlier in the previous diagram. Calcium channel, voltage gated calcium ions are there. These are the vesicles, which contains neurotransmitters. Receptors are there. This is the cleft. This is the electrical synapse. Action potential is generated. These are known as the gap junctions, and the electrical stimulus is transferred from here to here. So in electrical transmission, the membranes of two cells actually touch each other and they share proteins with each other. This allows the action potential to pass directly from one membrane to the next. They are very fast, but found in only heart and eye cells. As far as electrical transmission is concerned, in a chemical transmission, electrical activity in the presynaptic neuron is converted into the release of chemical called neurotransmitters. I have already told you that bind to the receptors located in the plasma membrane of the postsynaptic cell. This is the mechanism. This is the presynaptic knob-like structure. This is the postsynaptic one, and inner one you can see. This is the polarized state, normal. This is depolarized state, and the presynaptic vesicles are there. They are diffusing with the membrane, and the neurotransmitter is collected there, and it is perceived here. So, this is basically the structure. Neurotransmitters are synthesized in this part, in the form of vesicles. They are transported down to the axon. Action potential travels down the axon. Now, action potential causes the calcium to enter, evoking the release of neurotransmitters. Now, as calcium is higher inside, neurotransmitter attaches, a neurotransmitter is released in this synaptic cleft. It is attached to the neurotransmitter receptor. Now, neurotransmitters separate from the molecules of the receptors and reuptake of neurotransmitters again. So this is basically a cycle-like structure. Again is the mechanism. Action potential depolarizes the axon terminal. The depolarization causes the calcium-gated ions to open. So calcium moves inside. Calcium enters, triggers exocytosis, and neurotransmitter is released, neurotransmitter diffuses across the synaptic cleft and binds with the receptors here. And the remaining neurotransmitter is reabsorbed. Thank you so much, students. We'll catch you for the further sessions. Thank you so much.